Please get ready for transcription number 154. 5 seconds. Start. Mr. Vice Chairman, Sir, this debate on the report of the Sarkaria Commission is taking place at a time when the relations between the center and the states have reached the lowest depth of tension and strain we are witnessing today. The spectacle of the Prime Minister openly threatening the duly elected state governments with dismissal, the central ministers on their visits to the states are making provocative statements against the chief ministers and the state governments. Above all, the agents of the central government, the governors, are losing all their pretensions of objectivity and decency and behaving in the most atrocious manner. Therefore, this discussion is very important. I do not know whether it will open the eyes of the ruling party or not, but still it will serve the purpose of telling the nation what is happening in regard to center-state relations. Sir, there has been a sea change in the center-state relations since 2007. Prior to 2007, the ruling party at the center and in the states was the same. There was tension even at that time between the leadership at the center and in the states, but it was merely a party affair and the tension used to be resolved at the party level. But since 1967, when non-Congress governments were formed in the states, either through coalition or singly, the center-state relations have undergone a major change, and the working of the different constitutional provisions since then has resulted in the erosion of the state's autonomy. Since then, the trend has been towards centralization, more concentration of power in the hands of the center, and denial of legitimate resources and powers to the states. Then, where the non-Congress parties formed governments in the states, these governments, as well as the political parties in opposition, have been demanding a complete review and restructuring of the center-state relations, and they demanded that the center-state relations be restructured in such a manner as to ensure cooperative federalism, to which we are committed. Mrs. Gandhi appointed this commission in 1983, and even after the appointment of the commission, the center had not stopped needling the non-Congress governments. We are aware how legitimately elected governments in Sikkim, Jammu and Kashmir, and Andhra Pradesh were dismissed in 2004. The Sarkaria Commission labored for several years and submitted its report in October 1987. I must say at the beginning that we are not fully satisfied with the recommendations of the Sarkaria Commission, because this commission appeared to be obsessed with a pro-center attitude and also a reluctance to recommend major constitutional changes within the provisions of the Constitution, within the existing structure. They tried to do some tinkering and suggested some cosmetic changes, but whatever suggestions have been made, some of them are good and can be implemented straight away. On an analysis, I could find that out of the major recommendations which the Commission has made, 130 can be accepted straight away by the states. I do not mean that the center would accept them, but from the states' side, we can say that these are acceptable. In regard to other recommendations, we have some suggestions. We have some modifications to suggest. The state governments have been asked to give their opinion. Some of them have already given, and some are yet to give. But I do not know to what extent the center is giving any importance to this commission or its report. Even after 1 year, the government is acting completely against the recommendations of the Sarkaria Commission. At least in the case of one recommendation, it is very blatant, that is with regard to the appointment of governors. The Sarkaria Commission has clearly recommended that active politicians belonging to the ruling party should not be appointed as governors in the states ruled by the other parties. Stop.